What I am going to speak on now, it is a dynamic Kirpet subtalar ankle calcaneum frame. So this is my hospital where I worked. Now, everybody listen? Voice is clear? Okay, fine. Thank you. So this is a recent article, point, counterpoint. Now, is it time to retire internal fixation of calcaneum fractures? So it's like a Greek mythology, Icarus, who has got wings of wax and feathers. If he flies close to the sun, his wings will melt. If he flies close to the ocean, his feathers will get wet and he will not able to fly. So in calcaneum, we have same type of confusion. So don't fly too close to the sun. So this is my crazy idea, and I have unleashed at least to the orthopedic community. So what is my dynamic frame? Now this is a recent article, 2013, subtalar distraction osteogenesis for post-traumatic arthritis following intra-articular calcaneum fracture. Now same principle, that is subtalar distraction osteogenesis, if it works in old calcaneum fracture also, it should work in acute calcaneum fracture. So these are the history. People have tried lot of trials and methods, maneuvers from the history point. So to reduce the calcaneum and to get a good outcome. And this is a frame designed by Harris. We all know that Harris view, axial view. So what are the point and counterpoint? Percutaneous approach using external fixation can outperform traditional open reduction and internal fixation. And why should we refine internal fixes for intra-articular fractures of the calcaneum? Now, recent research has shown that if you manage surgically, means if you let it go, there are chances of subtalar joint arthrodesis 6 times more. So calcaneum fractures, this is in JBJS, American, 2013 edition. Now, what are the points? Why should we go for external fixation? So, internal fixation we should avoid because it needs time, wrinkle sign. There are soft tissue complications. There are iatrogenic acute neurological injuries. And this both grows up to 50% of any operative by any hand, even skilled hand also. And post-traumatic is a devil, always follows your work. And return to work is the most delayed in internal fixation cases. And second surgery is inevitable. So these are the points which favors external fixations. So it is a rigid stabilization. It is a minimal invasion, skin, soft tissue problem, peripheral vascular. You can use in medically comorbid patients like tau, uncontrolled diabetes, smoking. And it allows, or it is a modulation of distraction of the subtalar joint, which, while not proven, may be protective of the cartilaginous surface, that is subchondral surface, as we mentioned in that previous article, that it works in old calcaneal fracture also. So doing surgery on calcaneum is like a dead picture. Whenever you put a hand and knife over calcaneum, you should remind, this picture should be in the mind. So these are the basics. There are two types, tongue and depress, and angles to be measured. What are the concerns while fixing calcaneum fractures? That is the height of a calcaneum, width of a calcaneum, length of a calcaneum, and posterior facet disruption, which will lead to arthrosis. But most common is apparent bulge of the lateral wall, which will give you peroneal impingement. If you find calcaneum malunion patient, 60 to 70% of the patient will complain of this lateral wall impingement, that is subfibular impingement. And anatomic, for this, you have to reduce as possible as to this, reduce these parameters. So these are the X-rays parameters you have to measure, that is Bowler's angle, height of the calcaneum, length of, this is normal contralateral, X-ray should be taken. And these are the angles, three angles. And that is varus valgus angle on a Harris axial view. These are the scales, that is the measurement of the calcaneum. You have to take a measurement after post-reduction or post-fixation. So This is a Sanders classification, Roy Sanders from Florida. He has got confusion. Even if I put whatever type of newer plate, there are chances of 8% failure rate, apart from soft tissue and skin. So this is a one disaster from surgery. This is a simple tongue fracture, can be managed by K-wire also. And surgeon tempted to do this, and it leads to amputation. So looking at the malunion, if you don't follow the parameters, what are the type of malunions? This is a JVIP classification, that is subtalar incongruency, which is very common. Additional heel varus, which leads to ankle arthrosis also. There is additional loss of hind foot height, which will lead to tendo Achilles dysfunction. Additional lateral translation, which leads to peroneal impingement. And additional talar tilt, which leads to ankle arthrosis. So the most effective and protective way to treat calcaneum malunion is try to avoid it at the first strike. This we all know, that is pathomechanics. This is primary fracture line. Axial loading will lead to secondary fracture line. And this is EL maneuver also. So how this ligamentotaxis work? This is an article published in 2008. Treatment of displaced intraarticular calcaneum fractures by ligamentotaxis. Same thing Dr. Prakash has said about wrist. So same type of ligamentotaxis principles works here. So these are the ligaments, not going in detail into the anatomy, as we are going to put up this PPT in WhatsApp also. So these are the calcaneofibular ligament, lateral talocalcaneum ligament, interosseous talocalcaneum ligament, and the main ligament is interosseous talocalcaneum ligament. So this is the interosseous talocalcaneum ligament. When there is a stretch between talus and calcaneum, this will reduce the fracture. And another is peroneal this extensor retinaculum is also a bridge between tibia and calcaneum. So this is the medial root, this is the intermediate root, this is lateral root of extensor retinaculum, which will help to reduction. This is a medial exposure of ligament, and interosseous lateral talocalcaneum ligament. This is cervical ligament, and this is the anatomic cadaveric this picture. So this ligament, as I said, interosseous talocalcaneum ligament is the heart of ligamentotaxis, and it is not disturbed or nor injured in any type of calcaneum fracture. As you know, we know rather, that is a constant fragment of sustentaculum is always present. So this is interosseous talocalcaneum ligament. And when you put a frame, when you put a talus as a fulcrum, and if you distract this, this ligament will reduce our posterior facet and middle facet also. So when ligament is attached, and this is a simple reduction maneuver, this is a constant fragment, and this is a ligament attached on the lateral side. When you distract it, when you disimpact it, and when you do it a valgus pus, whatever, primary displacement against, it will reduce. But when ligament is torn, this ligamentotaxis may not work, or you have to use a EL maneuver, that is Essex laparoscopic maneuver. And this Elizarov principle of olive wire connection, and you have to introduce wire from as per your primary displacement. Now this is a talar wire picture. You have to introduce first talar wire in a neck, and second not far it, but in the just behind that neck of the talus. You have to palpate a navicular head, and then just 1 centimeter behind that, you have to put a talar wire. No doubt this picture shows olive wire, but it is not required. And this is an anatomical blood supply. You are not disturbing a blood supply of talus by doing this. And this is a safe zone of calcaneum. Now talar wire perpendicular, when you put a limb, talar wire will be perpendicular to your limb, or tibia sheen rather. And calcaneum wire should be perpendicular of the tuber. That is, if tuberosity is in varus, your wire will go like this. If tuberosity is in this tuber is in valgus mode, your wire will go like this. So when you straighten it, it will valgus and varus will be corrected. So this is the actual picture, actual view after calcanium wire. And you have to arc it. Arcing will bring the calcanium at a 45 degree angle distraction by doing this. So this is an arc wire calcanium described by Dror Perry also, but not for calcanium fractures. And you can joystick olive wire talus as a fulcrum pivot point. You can maneuver any type of calcanium fragment by doing this simple cross wire fixations. And this I saw, okay, when tuberosity is in varus mode, your wire should go from lateral inferior to medial superior. And when you correct it, when you distract it, when you make it equal length with the talar wire, your calcanium is reduced. So this is dual. Duals means opposite static wire. Once from olive wire from one side, and you have to maintain counter from another side. Means dual static wire. That is, it is a positional wire only. It is not contributing to reduction. So in history also, there are lot of this information about how to reduce calcanium. This is single point distraction, putting some bowl, that mass behind the tendo Achilles and stretching it. This is 2 point distraction using tibia and calcanium. And this is 3 point distraction using talus, calcanium and cuboid. And this is Harry's frame we already saw. So, and in 3 point distraction, you can use it as a talar apex. I am using it this as a talar apex. My reduction is always at the talar. Or you can use it at the calcanium apex if the anterior tuberosity is not damaged. This is calcanium apex. And these are the fixator available in the market, Western market. This is Orthofix first fixator. They are using hub pins. It is reduction is there, but it is static. And as we know, all the hazards of this cross pin, this hub pin in cancellous bone. So what is the difference between this fixator and my idea? That is, it is a distraction capsulo-ligamentotaxis at subtalar joint. It is a cartilage. It will help in cartilage regeneration. Why? Because it allows movement in a proper axis. Calcaneum parametric reduction, you can reduce it after 2 days, 3 days if you find it uncomfortable. Subfibular impingement, this is the main point. You can avoid subfibular impingement by constant movement, and there will be a peroneal gliding movement will occur, and it will mold that callus on the lateral side of the calcaneum. There will be a dynamic tension bend on plantar flexion, dorsiflexion, like tension bend wiring due to arced wire. And there will be a plantar ligament pool, which will help full optimizing tendo Achilles. And even it works when it is non-loaded, that is elastic recoil of arced wire. So this is Orthofix again. Now they have made it hinged. But this is only on unilateral side, not bilateral side. And what are the advantages of hinge Illy-Jarrow calcaneum? Motion sparing, but not dynamic. It indicates that it allows 20 degree of ankle movement without alteration of the rotation axis, and suggests that this type of external fixator can be used in all type of calcaneum fracture, regardless of the soft tissue damage. This is American College of Foot and Ankle evidence. And this is a friend of mine from Rome, that is Mario Tangari. He uses as an orthogonal fixation. This is calcaneum fixation by him. This is Russian way, described in Russian. Mine is step 4, that is step 1 is talar wire, step 2 is calcaneum wire, step 3 is distraction, and step 4, if you are not able to achieve calcaneum length, you can use cuboid wire. So step 1, talar wire. In this picture it is shown cross, but I am using nowadays parallel wire, and that to plain wire, not cross. Why? Because of deltoid injury. It may lead to deltoid injury. So this is talar wire. First, that is 5/8 ring. You have to measure a ring size from the foot size. And then you introduce first talar wire in the talar neck, and just behind it, talar parallel wire. This is five-eight ring talar fixation, and this was cuboid fixation also. It will help to regain length in calcaneum. And this is calcaneum wire now. First wire medial from calcaneus, as I said, lateral inferior to medial superior. Second is lateral calcaneum. Both are olive. Both are compressing the lateral bulge also, especially lateral olive. And this is the dynamics of the fixation. Hinge at 45 degree. Initially, we were doing this, but nowadays we are putting perpendicular threaded rod between two rings only, as we are using arced wire now. So reduction platform is floor ring, arced wire in lieu instead of this straight 45 degree hinge, and it is a three-hole band which is very strong, and it will allow will not allow angular movement between the wire and bone. So reduce elevation, you can use extra wire and compress it with the inferior part of the calcaneum if it is there is a tuberosity fracture. This is another same mechanics, but this ring is not necessary, tibial ring. This is talar ring, calcaneum ring, and this is tuberosity K wire. You can use it from the ring, from the calcaneum ring. And you can place many wires, as many as wire, as we saw that calcaneum safe zone. You can introduce according to the geometry, whatever type is there. Posterior facet wire, this is tuberosity wire. This is compressing from superior inferior. And this is bringing down the calcaneum. And this figure should be in the mind of the medial neurovascular structure while introducing calcaneum wire. You can introduce at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 wire into calcaneum when you are crossing it. And you can use supplementary tips as push screw from the inferior plantar aspect, or additional tibial as Dr. Yunus is going to describe it. And this is my case. This is an anterior combination where nothing will work. Calcaneum plate will also not work in this fracture. This patient is an alcoholic, fall from third floor. And this is a CT scan. See, nothing will work over here. So this is the first case using stack frame, how I get the idea. So it is a crush combination fracture of the calcaneum. And this is a talar wire. This is calcaneum wire. And both ring, you will see, it will form a complete O when you see it from the axial side, plantar side. And this is arced wire combination. It will pull the calcaneum and it will be flexible fixation. When there is an ankle dorsiflexion, it will pull the calcaneum. When there is a plantar flexion, it will downgrade the calcaneum. So this is a distracted, this is what I'm telling, this is the distraction of the calcaneum. You should achieve this distraction on table. You have to see this posterior facet. This is a ring, and this is now I am using threaded rod between two. You can distract directly when you are using arced wire. No need to go for 45 degree hinge. And this is a reduction after application. See the distraction. This is video, but it will not play over here. And this is after 6 months. And the point I am, this is peroneal tunnel. You can see peroneal is tunneling through the scalo-osseous tunnel. This is also video, but it is not displaying. And this is after 1.5 year. So, in conclusion, controlled dynamization of the fracture is likely to stimulate bone healing, while ankle motion is likely to minimize the development of adhesion and pathological contracture, especially peroneus, because peroneus is passing through the ankle within the capsular ligamentous apparatus above the calcaneus. Distraction arthroplasty is a now upcoming concept in ankle as well as in elbow and probably in knee osteoarthritis also. Distraction helps to remodel cartilaginous. Newer application study, Dr. Himanshu, he is not present over here, but he has got numerous application how to trap the dragon. And heel width, valgus and plantigrade foot promotes, this is the main thing, weight bearing. Patients started weight bearing within 2 weeks after this application. So when there is a axial loading, heel width, valgus and plantigrade foot promotes combination healing in adjusted position. So whatever calcaneum, as when it is work in neglected calcaneum also, it works, then it should work over here also. And absorption gliding tendineous peroneal surface. Thank you very much.